the house.
What up, what up, coach?
MP, we got one heck of a matchup tonight.
Man, I know, and I can't wait.
Top-notch second units for both teams. That could be the difference in this game, Clark.
You know, depth is so important in this league. You know, everybody can play, but you have to have quality depth and teams that understand their respective roles within their group. So managing their stars' minutes is important, and that's part of what depth allows you to do. So you need guys that understand their roles and are ready to produce every game.
A look at the 76ers starting group. Harris and Embiid are playing up front. De'Anthony Melton out there with James Harden. And it's Thybulle in at the small forward position. Now here's Harden. And that one makes him 2 for 2. He's in his rhythm.
A threat to score from anywhere. I love when Harden attacks when he's near the bucket.
And that streaking rack attack is the mobile one drive.
Yeah, and in close games like this one, B.A., you need toughness. Guys who will run to the fight and get after
him. The Sixers, you instantly think of Joel Embiid.
Oh, no question. He's the face of this franchise. Embiid is as good as anyone in the league. Off the floor, Joel is willing to take the blame when things don't go right. That's who you want as a leader.
And Grant, no team better than Miami at developing undrafted prospects.
I mean, for key roles, too. You look at last year's playoffs, Strus, Martin, Vincent, Robinson. It's allowed Miami to stay on top in a salary cap-driven league.
Adebayo finds Young. Good! And the assist goes to Adebayo.
It's going to take a lot more than that to keep Young from converting that play.
Hero against Melton. Up top, Harden. Puts it up from the high post. Oh, and that one had the right spin on it. It's good. Harden's gotten his third basket of the night.
Starting to find his rhythm. He's cooking, and he knows it.
And you know what? They're going to keep using it. I mean, he'll be the centerpiece of their offense today. You can bank on that.
Now here's Cobb. And his scoring average of 31.5 points a game is fantastic.
A rare miss for him at point-blank range. That's one he'd like to have back.
Cobb on the wing for three. Knocks down the long J.
You know, Jimmy's really a great playmaker from the wing spot. And I think at times, Butler can play point forward.
Harden, a pass to Harris. From deep, Melton. That one doesn't drop. For Miami, they've gone just 2 for 4 from the floor. Inside. And Cobb gets it to go on the assist by Adebayo. Cobb's got his second bucket on the night.
For a center, Adebayo is an excellent passer. He's always so aware of his surroundings. Ooh, he's piping hot. 4 for 4 from the field. No one can guard him out there.
Certainly looks that way to me, partner. I mean, his energy level is ramped up. I think he's been terrific right from the opening tip.
Now here's Hero. His offense has been solid, scoring around 11.5 points a game. Butler with the bucket.
Tit for tat. Love that Butler came back down and delivered.
Whatever you can do, he can do just as well.
Melton passes to Embiid. Now here's Harden. Yes, and it's Embiid picking up the assist. Harden's got 11 points.
Off to a great start. 5 straight from the field.
And the defense hasn't been able to do anything to stop him. And when that's the case, just keep feeding the hot hand.
He goes up, flushes it down to finish the break.
Good fast pace. Easier to find a shot when you beat the defense back.
And a look now at how the offensive approach has been going here so far for the 76ers.
Well, we've seen them take advantage of the lanes given to them so far. The defense isn't plugging it up, and it's being exploited.
In addition to that, how about the mid-range action we've seen from this group? Utilizing the jump shot to get them started in the right manner in this one.
Now here's Harris. What, no scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change.
Couldn't quite line that one up. Just got to shake it off and move on to the next one.
Here's Hero. Butler, a screen on Thibault. Here's Hero. No good, a bit long that time. For Philadelphia, they've got 6 of 8 shots to go. Harris passes to Melton. Back to Harris.
Tough call for his coach. Second foul already.
The Sixers leading. So on the floor for Philadelphia to kick off the second quarter. Up front, it's Tucker at the 4, next to Embiid in the middle. Goran Dragic is out there with De'Anthony Melton, and it's Thibault in at the 3. Now here's Thibault. In his last outing, 8 points for him. 5 to shoot. Here's Melton. And it's Miami with a rebound. They're coming off that loss against Philadelphia.
It was poor efficiency scoring the ball. They needed too many attempts to get their points.
Yeah, and I think they just seem to be a page behind, a step slower out there all game.
Cobb with it, covered by Thibault. The 3 ball. Cobb's shot is off.
Not his best night, and not the team's best night. Sometimes it just goes that way.
Pass to Melton. To the inside, Tucker. And he comes up with a bucket. Tucker's got 5.
Yeah, you got to do a lot more than that against Tucker, fellas. He's too big, too strong at times for the defense. This is really amazing. I mean, from March 1st, 2014 to October 26, 2016, Joel Embiid didn't play in a basketball game. 31 long months, rehabbing back and foot injury.
And it's the Sixers with the ball. The Heat making their last shot. Now here's Dragic, guarded by Cobb. And the basket by Dragic. Dragic has gotten his second bucket. I'll give Philadelphia credit. They didn't rush Embiid back.
They, in fact, trusted the process, pun intended, folks. And Joel has returned the favor. An MVP caliber center who changes a franchise. He is a franchise cornerstone piece. A great example of how being patient and doing what's best ends up being a winning combination for all.
And the Heat making a change here. Oladipo's checked in. And here in the second, 2 minutes gone by. Here's Cobb. Oh, and there's the whistle on the coming up. You know, for most players, being a starter has value. But Grant, some elite teams have been elevated by great players who have accepted a reserve role.
And it's really special, BA, when you have that. Players who are willing to sacrifice for the greater good of the team. Putting winning first at all costs. And you think about it, through the years, Manu Ginobili with the Spurs, Andre Iguodala in Golden State, it really can galvanize a team and lead to winning championships.
Now here's Melton. He picked up 10 in his last game. No luck on that one. Oh, great D that time from Adebayo. To the paint. Here's Butler. And Tucker pulls it down. Philadelphia has gone 3 of 6 from deep so far. Dragic right side. Adebayo grabs the board. Adebayo's got rebound number 5 here tonight. And Cobb slams it home.
Impressive one-hand slam right there, BA.
Man, it's a 76ers. You know what time it is, man. Make some
noise. That's how you defend.
And it's the Sixers with the ball. And now about 3 minutes gone in the second quarter here. Now here's Dragic, tightly guarded. Melton with the ball. Hero picks him up. Just 4 to shoot. Melton attacking. And it's Miami with a rebound. Adebayo's got 6 rebounds in the game. The 3 from Cobb. Rebound by the 76ers.
Boy, just not scoring with the efficiency he'd like to. Tough quarter for him.
Dragic outside. Pass to Embiid. Fires for 3. That one's good from Dragic. On the assist from Embiid. Dragic has got 7.
Well, that's just good heads-up basketball from Embiid, making the pass to the open man.
Outside Cobb. Here's the 3. The shot misses. The 76ers go the other way with it.
Man, miss after miss for him. When you're having a quarter like this, the only beneficiary is the defense.
Dragic outside. To the middle. Here's Embiid. Misses with the fallback, Jay. Miami trailing. All right, let's get a report from Allie.
Thanks, B.A. Well, Joel Embiid drawing comparisons to some legendary big men. He said, quote, "I want to be mentioned as one of the greats. That's my goal. And obviously being a Hall of Famer. But you've got to take step by step, one day at a time. It's going to take a lot of work, and I'm willing to put it in."
Joel Embiid. Third person foul. Third team foul.
Such a spirited player, and you can see his teammates enjoy it as well.
And both free throws good for Adebayo. Well, an all-star appearance for Bam Adebayo in 2020. Grant, you think he can get back there?
No doubt. I mean, I think the bigger issue is we've seen his numbers taper off just in the postseason. Can he reverse that and bring his best when it matters most?
Now here's Dragic. He has 7. Takes it inside, up and in on the layup. Dragic has got 7 points here in the quarter.
Well, he's cooking with grease. He's got things flaming up, looking for an opportunity every time down the floor when he's that hot.
Pass to Hero. Here's Butler. Adebayo sets a screen. Butler finds Adebayo. Melton against Hero. The baseline, Jay. No good, off the front rim. The Heat have gotten only 2 of 8 field goals to go in the second. And a deep 3 from Cobb. Off target with the 3.
He hasn't been able to find his touch this quarter.
To me, it appears he's starting to lose his composure a little bit. We'll see if he can regroup and get back into a better rhythm.
Now here's Dragic. An 11-point game for him in the win against Miami.
And another key for them was his rebound. Just a great effort.
Cobb with it. Defended by Dragic. Oladipo, left side. Back to Cobb. And there's the drive. The shot comes out. Some solid defense by Dragic. Philadelphia's got 4 of 7 threes to go so far in this game. Here's Melton. Denied by Adebayo.
Oh, gotta be cautious. Showing once again that he's a legitimate shot blocking.
Here come the fans, everybody. Let's get loud. For your Miami Heat dancers.
Step back shot, and that's good. Off the glass that time. Harden's got 13 now.
They just look so overwhelmed inside. You know, that's why they continue to get attacked.
Yeah, I think they've got to ramp up the aggressiveness. If they don't, things are just going to get worse from here.
Wow, he doesn't make those kind of plays too often. Sweet move inside.
Pass to Tucker. Outside Harden. Six to shoot. Oh, he remains perfect. 7 for 7, showing no signs of letting up.
Defensively, they've got to get more bodies in the paint. That's 3 straight field goals from below the free throw line.
Hero outside. Adebayo, a screen on Melton. Hero with it. Picked up by Embiid. And a foul called on the wall.
Joel Embiid. 4th personal foul. Team foul number 4. Now at the line.
They're punking you, MP. Tee up.
So Hero nails both of them. And so a close game as we wrap up the first half of play. Heat out in front.
Miami Heat, 61. The 76ers, 58.
Hi, and in the West, Luka Doncic. Circling back to our featured game, the Miami Heat find themselves in a pretty even matchup.
They're winning this game at the line, Shaq, somewhere where you really don't like to be. But they've got crafty scorers. They know how to pick their spots. I mean, they're stacking up the freebies.
Freebies? You know how many free throws I shot in practice just to hit over 50%?
Shoot over 50%? No, you probably shot over 50 million just to get 50.
Yeah, listen, buddy. My percentage is 50.6. That's 51 if you round it off.
At all.
That does it for halftime. Let's get back to...
And in that first half, we saw a pretty tight battle. We'll soon find out what sort of adjustments were discussed during halftime. We are seeing an outstanding game from James Harden.
Yeah, tonight, he's done a great job of slashing through the lane and finishing.
Yeah, you know what, guys? They gave him too many free runs to the hoop in the first half. I think they've got to be a lot tougher on him. Body him up. Be physical with him.
On the wing, it'll be Hero and Butler. Bam Adebayo is out there with Thaddeus Young. And it's Cobb in at the point. That's the group on the floor for Miami. Now here's Harris. Pass to Embiid. This for the tie! Can't hit that one.
You gotta love how they've been crashing the boards, fighting hard for every miss.
I certainly do. You know I like to see guys do their work inside. Their rebounding has been excellent, and that's always important in a close game.
Outside Harden. Butler against Thibault. And here's Melton. Embiid, a screen on Hero. Melton passes to Embiid. And here in the second half of play, we're just over a minute in. Here's Cobb. Good! And the assist goes to Adebayo. Adebayo's got his 4th assist with that last one. Philadelphia's gotten 5 of 11 threes to drop so far in this game. Now here's Harden, guarded by Cobb. Harden misses. The Heat have got 2 of 3 from the floor in this third quarter. Cobb on the wing. Embiid covers. Young misses. The Sixers trailing. Thibault on the wing. Well, he hasn't scored yet, but I'm sure that'll change. Here's Embiid. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot.
There are high school refs better than you guys.
It is unstoppable, just too strong for the defense, no matter what they throw at him.
Outside Cobb. Pass to Butler. Now Young. Goes to the reverse layup and drops it in. Young's got 10.
Well, he's so skilled from this area. Once Young gets it in a good spot, he's looking to score.
Just under 2.5 minutes into this third quarter now. Harris down low. Young's there. Harris misses.
And they just continue to dominate the boards.
Guys, I think they've simply been the more physical team, and that's why they're ahead.
They have no answer defensively inside.
Yeah, and that's four straight field goals now they've allowed from point-blank range.
Can't happen.
Pass to Embiid. Over Adebayo. And another miss by Philadelphia.
Clearly out of rhythm now, guys. I mean, just 1 for 5 to begin the second half.
Cobb, no good. For Philadelphia, they've gotten just 1 of 5 shots to drop since halftime. Harden, the pass to Thibault. Melton outside. Harris left side. Embiid, a screen on Young. Harris finds Embiid. Over Adebayo. Adebayo grabs the board. Adebayo's got a rebound number 12 here already in the game. Down low. Oh, got a piece of it. Oh, stolen by Harden. Melton outside. Pass to Harris. Melton outside. Six on the shot clock. And he drops in the layup off the glass. He's got 5.
It doesn't get any easier than that. The defense has to play better.
And a deep 3 from Cobb. Again, the Heat misses.
You know, it hasn't been his best outing, but they still find themselves in the driver's seat here.
Pass to Harris. To the inside. And it's blocked! He keeps control of the ball!
His struggles this quarter are self-evident, and the team just continues to suffer for it.
Up top, Cobb, defended by Harden. With the fadeaway, and there it is for him. Cobb's got 8 here in this quarter. All right, guys, what's your take on the hustle stats for the Heat?
Their defense has been on point all game long. They're out hustling the shooters and swatting down plenty of shots.
The shooting's been great. They've been getting it up and down in transition, and that takes effort.
Butler up top, covered by Thibault. Shoots a fadeaway, and it's Philadelphia with the rebound. Embiid's got rebound number 10 tonight with that last one.
Well, the great ones make their mark in the playoffs, and Jimmy Butler has certainly done that. Some Herculean performances when the chips were down.
Now here's Harden. Give him 20.
And unlike some other guys, missing a wide open look won't hurt his confidence at all.
The 3 from Cobb, and the 3-pointer goes. Cobb's got 11 points here in the second half. And granted, last year's playoffs, Jimmy Butler became the first player since Jordan to author multiple 40-point, 4-steal games in a single series.
Oh, and in 2020, the third player ever to record a 40-point triple-double in the finals. I mean, just legendary stuff.
Now here's Adebayo. 12-point lead, their biggest of the game.
He's been tremendous at corralling misses all night long.
Yeah, I love the way he's fighting through box outs, using his elbow. I mean, he's doing whatever it takes.
Stolen by Harden. From deep, Melton. The Sixers again can't hit. For Miami, they've gotten 6 of their first 12 shots to drop in this third. Outside Cobb. Back to Adebayo. Inside. Thibault with a steal. Pass to Harden. Back to Thibault. Shot clock at 5. Here's Embiid. Lays it up and banks it in. Embiid's got 9.
You know, we see Embiid operate a lot from the perimeter, but he is clearly at his best owning the paint.
Here's Cobb. And it's Harris with the rebound. Philadelphia's gone 0 for 2 from outside here in the third. Thybul passes to Embiid. Back to Thybul. And he goes strong with the one-handed jam.
And what an aggressive move to the rim. He's really trying to fire up his teammates right now.
Boy, it's not hard to feel inspired after a teammate makes that kind of finish.
You know, when you're looking to close the gap, you need guys who will take it upon themselves to step up, take the initiative, and make something happen.
Now here's Thybul. Up top, Embiid. Again, the Sixers score.
They've now had assists on each.
Substitution here for Miami. Deadmond's checked in for Bam Adebayo. Martin comes in for Young. Oladipo's checked in for Jimmy Butler. And it's Lowry in for Hero. Now here's Lowry. He's been productive, averaging just over 7 points a game. Deadmond, a screen on Thybul. Back to Oladipo. Launches it. Cobb, no good. Philadelphia has gone 5 of 12 from three-point range tonight. Thybul, that's good. And now it's just a four-point Miami lead.
Yeah, exactly. It sure is. Plenty of second opportunities. 8 of their last 10 points from the paint, but the defense still continues to back away and not show any aggression.
Outstanding dribble drive. And that replay was brought to you.
Second personal foul. First team foul.
And a moment to look at the scoring. Dragic with it. So, on the floor for Philadelphia. Harden is the two with Harris playing small forward. Then it's Joel Embiid. And then it's Goran Dragic. And it's Reed in at the power forward position. Now here's Butler. The kick out to Cobb. Offline with a three.
At this point, I'm not sure if it's the play calling or the player himself.
Harris on the wing. Now here's Dragic. The D's right on him. Good.
Yeah, that's good vision from Harris. I mean, he draws so much attention himself, so he's become a capable passer.
Up top, Cobb. Defended by Dragic. Adebayo, a screen on Dragic. And here's Cobb for three. Philadelphia grabs the miss.
I think he's gone completely dry. Nothing is hitting.
And, you know, you can sense his frustration. Listen on the...
He's checked in for Dragic. And the free throw is good. Now leading by one. A few possessions into the fourth. Just over a minute played. Cobb drives in. And Embiid with the block.
Incredibly light-footed at 7 feet tall. Embiid can cover a lot of ground defensively.
Nice shot by Harden.
Their success from mid-range has really set them apart today.
Simply taking advantage of what the defense has given them, and they've really made the most of it.
Now here's Butler. Hero finds Oladipo to the middle. Here's Cobb. Harden with the defensive effort. The 76ers have gone 2 of 3 to open the fourth quarter. Here's Melton. Oh, a clear foul there on the missed shot.
Third person foul. Second team foul.
Shooting for Philadelphia. I mean, that's why the shot was so far off.
Young, he's checked in for Oladipo. The 76ers also with a sub. Thybul, he's checked in for Reed.
He did the important part at the line there. The heavy lifting, if you will. Made this a two-possession game.
And here's Kyle for three. And that'll be Miami's ball as it goes out of bounds. They keep the possession. And we're about 2 minutes into the fourth now. And the foul is called. He missed it.
James Harden. First team.
And he knocks down the first one.
Now at the line.
And Cobb drops them both.
And they've done well from the free throw line this half. No misses yet.
And that efficiency, as you know, so critical when you're looking to overcome a deficit. You've got to be close to perfect and can't waste scoring opportunities.
Embiid from outside. Yes, and a nice assist from Harden. Harden's got his third assist of the night.
One triple for him in the first half. Now he's hit another.
Offensively, it's been a struggle for him.
Yeah, they need to string together some shots to have any kind of chance.
Cobb, no good.
This has been a tough quarter for him and a challenging game for this team.
Melton passes to Harden. This one for three. Here's the second effort. Oh, the nice bucket inside from Embiid. And now it's a 7-point 76ers lead.
Hey, good luck trying to move Embiid off the block. If Joel has position, there's not much anybody can do to stop him.
Young, the pass to Butler. To the paint. And Adebayo slams it in.
The aggressiveness of Adebayo. He plays with so much energy and force close to the bucket.
Melton against Hero. Now here's Melton. Defense is right there. Here's Harden. Rebounded by Butler. Miami's gone 0 for 3 here in the fourth. Left side Cobb. Thibault with a steal. Harris outside. Inside. Here's Harden. And he's going to the line.
Third team foul.
Be your primary scorer, but he also can be your primary playmaker. Offensively, Harden does everything at a diamond level. Throughout years of play, one thing that has stayed consistent in the game of James Harden is remarkable ability to facilitate.
And it's Thibault missing. Miami trailing. Oh, stolen by Embiid. Outside Thibault. Pass to Harden. From deep. Pulls in another board. And he hauls in his 20th rebound.
Oh, just dominating the glass.
You know, with all he does offensively, at his size, Joel Embiid is like a cheat code for special talent.
You got to admit that Harden just has a gift for finding assists, Clark.
Yeah, he really does, B.A., and it's so amazing to watch. I mean, he's a guy that specializes in torching people one-on-one. But he's also almost as good setting other people up. Maybe it all comes back to how good he is at reading defenders. And I think there's something to be said for that.
Here's Cobb. The Sixers getting their last shot to go. And again, the Heat missing.
I wouldn't be surprised if he gets yanked soon. I mean, that's how bad his shot selection has been.
Outside Harden. Pass to Embiid. Outside Thibault. Fires the three. They get it again. Outside for Harden. From downtown. Rebound by the Heat. Adebayo's got rebound number 17, if you can believe that.
You know, after connecting on one three-pointer in the first half, he hasn't netted another one since.
And he got the whistle on the way up.
Once we get
prepare.
Right, it's over.
And he makes a first.
Now at the line.
And Cobb drops them both.
Making shots at the line. You need a good routine, and he certainly has one.
Pass to Harris. Now here's Melton. Back to Harris. Embiid with it. Pounded by Adebayo. Puts up a three. Gets the three to fall. And the 76ers lead by 11.
In order to create effective spacing, you need enough guys on the floor that can hit from downtown.
way outside. Second shot opportunity, and it's laid in by Adebayo.
From role player to all-star, Adebayo has made the leap. Why? Effort plays like that.
Harden from outside. Adebayo grabs the board. Adebayo's got rebound number 19 now. Incredible board work. Cobb shot is off.
He's trying to force his way into a rhythm, but that's not helping the team.
Harden, the pass to Thybul. Harris up top. Melton, right side. Pass to Embiid. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting.
Second personal foul. Team foul number 2. Shooting for Philadelphia.
See the Stars play more often. Cut the schedule back. Maybe 72 games. Grant, your thoughts.
You know, B.A., this is a problem and a concern, I think, for the league. You go back 20, 30 years ago, Stars played every night when available. Now you're not seeing that with the workload and the back-to-back and the concern with players and their safety and the amounts of money they make over their contracts. 72 games is a possibility, but I prefer to keep it at 82. Maybe I'm just a traditionalist.
Now here's Harris. Steps back. Here's Harden. It's rebounded by Cobb.
Nothing's going his way since the horn. I mean, last quarter.
Tucker's checked in for the Sixers.
76ers substitution.
Philadelphia shooting 47% on this one. Looking efficient. Melton passes to Harden. From outside the arc. No good. The Heat go the other way with it.
I like the aggressive approach. He's gonna have to be more efficient.
Here's Hero. So it'll be two free throws.
De'Anthony Melton. Second personal foul. Third team foul. Now at the line. Tyler Hero.
That one's no good. Here's Young. Finally, they hit one.
You know, those are the plays where you really see Young's quickness off the floor. He's got a great, quick second jump, which leads to second chance scores.
And Philadelphia.
You know what time it is, you say. Make some noise for your Heat Breaker Dance Crew. That was your Heat Breaker Dance Crew. Give them a round of applause.
They're making mistakes. Do not let them get comfortable. We'll see if they can maintain their disruptive ways down the stretch. Back to you.
Okay, thank you, Allie. And here's Harden. Pass to Melton. Embiid, a screen on Hero. Here's Embiid. Five on the clock. Harden with it. He's checked by Cobb. The Sixers again can't hit. And it's the Heat with the ball. Adebayo passes to Hero. Outside Butler. And he's going for the lob! And finished off by Adebayo.
Look how explosive Bam can be. Defenses can't do anything to stop him on the alley-oop.
The Sixers leading. Melton outside. Pass to Harden. Then Harden with the chance.
And he just driving the stake in him there.
He's a guy who just never lets up.
And that's terribly demoralizing for a defense, guys. I mean, they know he's going to keep coming and coming and coming, and that they may
national
team play. Matisse Thybul suits up for Australia down under. The team he meddled with in 2020.
Hey, it's fun to see NBA players like Thybul go their own way for national competition.
Yeah, it is, B.A. I mean, that's part of the interesting fabric of the global nature of the game, particularly as it relates to the NBA. International tournaments are kind of like an alternate world, if you will. Guys who are NBA rivals end up being teammates, or their teammates wind up on the other bench. It's actually pretty cool to see.
Now that their field goal percentage is starting to tail off, they're losing ground.
Now Embiid. Screen by Embiid. Melton outside. Pass to Thibault. Here's Harden. Guarded by Cobb. Shot is up. Here's Embiid. And the rebound paying off as they pick up two on the second chance bucket right there.
Coming out of the half now, making a commitment and concentrated effort to get to the offensive boards has proven fruitful.
Now here's Cobb. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up.
James Harden.
And he drops the first.
Now the line.
And Cobb drops them both. They can take their time if they want.
Yes, you have to regroup. Make sure you get a good shot.
Pass to Embiid. Over Adebayo. And that one's long. Miami trailing. Outside Cobb. Shoots over Harden. Miami, no good that time either.
Misfires again, and the ball just refuses to cooperate with him. It's a tough day so far.
Here's Melton. Oh, and makes it with the kiss.
That's a move you won't see many guys make. Impressive stuff.
And for the Heat, they're shooting just 38%. Their offense not where they want to be. Outside Butler. And he'll draw the foul. He'll head to the line for two.
When he's near the basket.
Butler hits them both. Here's Harden. A minute 39 left to play in the fourth. The three is up. He buries it from three. Harden's got 28 points for the game.
You can't let Harden get comfortable from outside the arc. I mean, he's capable of raining threes in bunches.
And he gets it back.
There's another opportunity, and everything's going right for these guys.
Thibault with it. Now guarded by Butler. Thibault, that's good. 1:14 left in the game. Pass to Young. Well, Clark, when you joined the NBA in 1982, there were around 300 players. Nowadays, it's over 500.
Yeah, you know, some would argue that's more opportunities, which is factual, but also others would say it's a little watered down now. But there are more good players, so I think it's basically an expansion of the talent level we see across the world. And the world is where the game is played, and that continues to be demonstrated by the number of international players that continue to make a mark on the NBA. So overall, I think it's a good thing to see the number of players expand at the NBA level.
Now here's Melton. Embiid denied by Adebayo. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Adebayo.
Thank you all for coming out and showing your great support. Please make sure to get home safely. We hope to see you again very soon.